Hey guys, today I want to talk to you about one of my favorite plants called Malva Moschata, or musk mallow. So this is musk mallow right here, this big, huge thing. This is my second year plant, and it's growing like a weed, as you can tell. Let me tell you a little bit about the basics of this plant. It grows in zones 3 through 8, so that's pretty good range in the United States. Native to Europe and Northern Africa. It grows to about 2 to 3 feet tall, or about half a meter to 1 meter tall, and it grows about 1 to 2 feet wide. That's about half a meter wide. Yeah, there's not too much hard scientific evidence on the benefits of this plant, but I did find two studies. A 2005 study suggests it has several therapeutic uses. The leaves can be used internally as a laxative, so if you're constipated, you could eat some of these leaves and it'll help clear you out. I'm sure it's probably due to the fiber more than anything, but still, I mean, it's great. The seeds can also be used and brewed into a tea, which can help relieve a sore throat. This plant also may have a very potent anti-ulcerative effect that has been demonstrated in its distant cousin plant, Malva sylvestris, and shares a lot of the same qualities as the Malva sylvestris plant, including its antioxidant and antibacterial properties. Another study done in 2002 that showed a methanol extract of Malva Moschata seeds showed significant antibacterial activity against 5 different strains of pathogenic bacteria. And it's pretty interesting, and I don't know what exact bacterial strains they're talking about, the pathogenic bacteria, but any antibiotic activity would be useful in this day and age of antibiotic resistance. So there's a good potential for this plant to be used in medicine dealing with pathogenic bacteria. Let me tell you why I like this plant. This plant is so easy to grow. I mean, I've done literally nothing to this plant, and maybe I give it a little water every now and then, but even then I don't think it really needs it with the amount of rain that we get here. It grows in full sun to part shade. It's also obviously a perennial. It comes back year after year, and it produces very showy pink flowers. You can see it's getting ready to flower right now. It's not quite there, but yeah, it produces little pink flowers that the bugs all seem to like, and they're also edible. Pretty much everything on this plant is edible. And one of the best parts about it is it tastes just like lettuce. If you're a fan of lettuce greens, which most people who eat salads are, you can easily have lettuce greens throughout the whole year with this plant, or lettuce equivalent plants. The texture is a little bit different, but the taste is almost exactly like lettuce. And I grew this is a second year plant right here, so it's a lot bigger than most of my other plants, but this year I grew a few more seeds, and here's what it looks like in the first year. It's a little smaller and the leaves are a little bit larger. Either way, it's a good plant to grow. And I could see if you had probably 7 or 8 of these plants, you'll have greens for the entire year. You'll be self-sufficient in greens for the entire year. So that is Malva Moschata, and common name of musk mallow. It's a great plant. I recommend everyone grow it. It's one of the best permaculture plants I've come across in a since I started gardening, basically, and really wanted to get the word out that this, how great of a plant this is. But that's it for today. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for more videos.